Adrian live from Stockholm for ESCplus.com, live from Friends Arena in Melodifestivalen in 2019. I was going to say this in Swedish, by the way, because I'm confused all the time with the languages. How do you feel, guys?
Good.
Six weeks. In Sweden.
Yes.
How does it feel for you?
It's weird, man. It's kind of like...
Everyone is asking this question all the time,
I thought of a new answer. No, but it's kind of like when you go on vacation, which I think everybody's done, you land on the airport and you check into the hotel and you're like, I'm never going to leave this place. And all of a sudden you're standing on the airport ready to go home. And it's exactly that feeling.
Yeah.
We started this trip like
good
6
analogy.
Months ago, where you were like, wow, this is never going to end. And now we're at the airport waiting to go home.
Yeah, Sarah, you've done this many times in the past. Is it your first time, Kodjo?
Yeah.
As a first-time host in Melodifestivalen, how does it feel? And for you, Sarah, to come back to do it again?
Well, I mean, it was me and Sarah, we've worked before, although it did take, what, six years for us to work again?
Six years
for us to work again, so that's been an amazing experience. And it's just been like a course in next-level hosting. I mean, there's been singing and dancing and going way, way outside of your comfort zone. So for me, it's been an amazing experience, and I think I've grown a lot.
And you also did some kind of surprise to your mother last week in Andra Chansen.
Yeah.
How was it? How did she take the surprise by Johnny Logan?
I mean, she's still on cloud nine. Every time I call her, she's like, "Hello, Kodjo. How are you?" "Oh no, me, oh, I'm fine." Yeah, she's gonna live on that forever.
And Sarah, what about you coming back to Melodifestivalen? And how does
it feel? Yeah, I think life in general for me is I have to constantly challenge myself and have new things that scare me in order for me to do them. And this was definitely a third time as a charm, but still there are a lot of things that I wanted to do better than the last time I did this. And I wanted to surprise myself. And so doing this with these three people and then the way we did it this year with a lot of interval acts and sort of numbers that maybe weren't my comfort zone, I wanted to basically grow, and I feel like I dared to do something that I wasn't really, really sure of, and it taught me a lot, and we had a lot of fun.
Great to hear.
Thank you.
Two last short questions. Eurovision, yes or no?
What, as
Sarah coming to Eurovision?
Oh, look, if you got me a ticket that I don't have to compete in the Swedish without, yeah,
yes,
go ahead.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Okay, Linda Woodruff, yes or no?
Yes.
Again?
Yes.
This Saturday?
Yes.
Perfect.
Yes.
Perfect. Thank you so much, guys.
You have to remember, I got to sing in the Eurovision without competing.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's hard to break that, man.
And that was an astonishing performance.
I mean, it was the best moment in my life. I got to do it, and I couldn't lose.
Yes. Thank you very much for your time, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Good luck with everything.
Thank you. You too.